Carpe diem. Are you familiarized with that phrase? Get ready. I want to share with you today about some information that I found regarding carpe diem. And the first one is that carpe diem means to urge someone to make the most of the present time and give little thought to the future. The second information that I found about this phrase is that it is an expression to ask someone not to waste time in useless things as a justification for the immediate pleasure without fearing the future. And then the last one is, I found it in the dictionary Merriam-Webster. It says, the enjoyment of the pleasures of the moment without concern for the future. Perhaps you've heard about this phrase as well, seize the day. Actually, literally, carpe diem means pluck the day, but it is translated as seize the day. There is a great truth in that phrase, and we need to seize the day because life is short. Life is too short, and the Bible says many times that life is like a cloud, you know? We see the clouds there in the sky, and then they pass by, and then disappear. We have to make the most of our time, and we don't have to waste the time that God has given us. Remember, time is a gift given from heaven, and we are going to give account of the time that we have on this earth. So let's live a life with a purpose that when we look back, we don't have any regrets because of wasted time. I want to share with you a Bible verse that is found in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10. Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. We know that Jesus Christ is going to come. But if he doesn't come in our time, we have a destiny. The destiny is death. And the Bible is clear on that. It says that everyone is going to the grave. Right? Our hope is to meet Jesus Christ alive, right? But if it is his will for us to go to rest, then what we can do? Now, how we can live a life with a purpose and then seize the day to find the real meaning of carpe diem? Do you remember that in one of the informations that I shared with you, it says that we don't have to worry about a future? Actually, we don't need to worry, but we need to have a consideration for the future, because the things that we do in the present are going to have an effect in the future, right? And if we live according to God's will, then of course we're not going to worry about a future, because our future is going to be the result of our life in the present time. Now the question is, how can we make the most of our time? I have some suggestions. I've been thinking a lot, you know, on how I can help people and give some advices that are going to be good for me as well. Not only for you, but for me first. And how we are going to make the most of our time. So the first one is read good books. You know, there is a bunch of books there outside in the world, and we can have, you know, different books that we can be reading today. And the first one, listen to this. The first one that we have to read is the Bible. I think you have that answer, right? So how often you are reading the Bible? How often we are having time to open God's Word and to talk to Him? Most of the time I've emphasized about reading the Bible because it's a matter of relationship, you know? When we pray, God listens to our prayers. He listens to us. But when we read the Bible, we can literally listen to the voice of God. Also, you have other alternatives, like you can choose a good book. There are a lot of educational books regarding health, science, education, you know, and also about motivation, inspiration. There are a bunch of books there outside. So you can choose one, and you can, you know, organize your time. You can choose which books are going to help you to grow up intellectually, spiritually, you know, and you're going to increase your knowledge as well, and you're going to be able to help other people. So think about that. That is my first suggestion. Now, the second one is prayer. We need to pray. You know, that is very important because prayer is what our soul needs. Prayer is not a waste of time. Prayer is very important because prayer is the breath of the soul. And that is what we need to do day by day, every single moment. And we have many examples in the Bible, like Daniel and David. They used to pray 3 times a day, right? And how often do we pray? Sometimes we just pray, you know, oh Lord, please help me this day and give me your blessing. But we don't have time to give thanks to Him. We don't have time to ask Him for knowledge. And we don't have time to pray for others. So let's think about that. Let's pray. Let's go to God. You know, we can kneel down. You can pray wherever you are. Just talk to God and share what you are feeling, what your thoughts are, what your plans are as well. And He is able to answer a prayer of faith. The third advice is regarding our time with watching TV shows, internet, series and episodes after episodes. You know, today people are watching sitcoms and all this stuff. How are you using your time regarding those things? Are those things getting you closer to God? Let's think about that. How are we using our time regarding those things? Are those things that we are watching helping us to grow a relationship with God? We have to ask for wisdom, and God is going to give us the wisdom that we need in order for us to choose things that are going to help us to stay closer to God. And think about that. And my question would be, are those things that we are watching helping us to come closer to God? You don't need to answer to me, but you have the answer. And I hope God is going to help us to make the most of our time. The fourth advice is regarding our time with social media. You know, many times and different times I've caught myself watching these pictures of my friends and of other people, and this a lot of information, and I spent like even more than an hour just scrolling down my screen and watching this information. And then when I saw the time, it was more than an hour, and I said, oh my goodness. And I really regretted that because I could have done something more useful, correct? And maybe that is happening to you as well. I'm not saying that you cannot socialize and that socializing is a sin. No, you can also use technology to the honor and glory of God. You can share Bible verses with people. You can share videos like this with your friends and help them to grow their relationship with God. And we can use technology, you know, to help other people to stay closer to God. Now, if you are at school, don't waste your time. Study. Go there and study. Don't waste your parents' money, or if you are at university, don't waste your money. Just go and study and make the most of your time. Get the knowledge that you need in order for you to build up a career and also to be, you know, useful in society and to be a blessing for others as well. And now if you are in holidays, you know, you can relax, you can rest a little bit, but then after that, you know, let's be useful. Let's help other people. Go and find a job. You know, it can be a part-time job. It can be something that you can go and help somebody as well to do something, right? If somebody needs you, you are going to be available for them. So, you see, there are these things that I wanted to mention today in order for us to make the most of our times. And also, if you have some comments regarding this Carpe Diem topic, you can leave your comments down below as well and share with us how we can improve in order to make the most of our time. I want to share a phrase with you now, and I really like this phrase because it makes me think a lot, and also I think it is going to help you. And it is, work as if you were going to live 100 years, but live as if Jesus Christ was going to come today. It's a beautiful phrase, and it's a powerful phrase. So work as if you were going to die in 100 years, but live your life as if Jesus Christ was gonna come today. Okay, that's the message for today. That is what I wanted to share with you. And please leave your comments down below. Share with others this message and be a blessing. God bless you and have a nice week.